Andrew here, Sterilizer Autoclave Solutions, 704-966-1650, option 3 for free technical support. So we're going to talk about Charlie 982 error code. High limit thermostat open for at least 0.25 seconds during fill mode. Number one, we're going to want to do our maintenance. If it has not been performed, cleaning of filters and draining of water and among other things, refer to the video on maintenance, weekly and monthly maintenance. Next thing is sterilizer was unplugged and then plugged back in while thermostat was still tripped. Okay, so if you have an error and you have to reset it, you have to unplug the unit and you have to wait 60 seconds. So unplug the unit, wait 60 seconds, replug the unit back in, that will erase the last error code. So then we also want to pull all the instruments out and run an empty cycle. Make sure that the unit was not overloaded. That's the first thing that we'll try. Pull all the instruments out, all the trays out, let it cool down for 5 minutes, shut the door and run another load. If you get 982 again, we're going to dig a little bit deeper. We'll have to take the right side panel off. There you will be able to reveal burnt or bad wiring. You're going to look in the back here at these connectors, the white and the black wire, burnt connectors there. You're going to look for burnt fuse holders on the green boards. You're going to look for burnt connectors. You're going to look under here with a flashlight, and that's where the overheat, over temp thermostats are. That's where you're going to look with a flashlight. If you see burnt connectors there, we're going to have to replace those before we can go to the next cycle. So let's visually inspect all that stuff. Also, if the unit skips the fill mode, obviously this is hot. It failed an error code. We're going to let it cool down. We're going to open the door, and we're going to make sure that the tray rack and or the rack here and the tray plate are pushed in all the way. This should be about an eighth inch back inside the chamber. All the trays shouldn't be out. We should, you know, this should be a test empty cycle at this point. But okay, so next will be the mesh filters not in place. So I'll show you the mesh filter. It's trays out. Crack the tray plate out. Mesh filter is inside here. This is the mesh filter. You're going to want to make sure this is clean. If it's not clean, you're going to rinse it with speed clean, a toothbrush, some distilled water, hold it up to the light, make sure you can see through it, and then reinsert. If that was clogged, that could have been the issue. Run another cycle. If error persists, we'll move to the next phase. If your office is running back-to-back cycles, that often is a problem. Back-to-back cycles is a problem. So what you're going to do is just let it cool down. In between cycles, wait 5 minutes or so, let it cool down in between cycles. Water level sensor is malfunctioning. Dirty or foreign objects touching sensor. So when you're cleaning the mesh filter inside there, inside the chamber in the back is the water level sensor. You can't see it here, but you're going to visually inspect inside there, make sure there's nothing touching it, make sure there's nothing, no paper back there, no buildup. Give us a call. We can kind of talk you through that. That's usually not a common thing from what I've seen. Okay, so if the unit completes the fill mode, we're going to verify that the sterilizer is level. And then if you're running a test cycle, we're going to look for pressure leaks. We're going to look for worn door gaskets, worn out door gaskets, worn out dam gaskets, improper positioning of those. If they are improperly positioned, then we're going to put them in the right position and we're going to run a test cycle, see if they are persists. Also, we're going to look at this ring here. Make sure you have one. If you're getting steam, if you got a new gasket in there and you're getting steam leaking, you can take that out. Take the ring out and run a test cycle and see if that ring was the problem. Okay, pressure leak there. From there, we're gonna have to take the cover off and kind of dig a little bit deeper, but it could be your fill valve is leaking, could be your vent valve is leaking, it could be your pressure relief valve is leaking. This is your pressure relief valve. It's right here. If it is leaking, you will see steam down in the back right-hand corner of the unit. But also, again, that could be these two valves leaking down below. You know, if we get this far after you run an empty cycle and you still haven't found the problem, let's talk and we can kind of walk you through further steps. Pressure. Okay, so we're talking pressure leaks. Could also be this pressure tubing. Make sure it's positioned like this, or and then it's connected to this piece here. That's what reads the pressure inside on the digital screen here. But if that's leaking all over the place, that could cause an issue. All right, Charlie 982 error code. Charlie 982. Okay, so if the unit completes the fill mode continued, more pressure leaks. There's a defective air, possibly a defective air valve. This is back here. You'll have to take the cover off. Refer to the video to take the cover off to look at the valve. But I would call anybody before you do that. Sometimes the orifices go bad. Sometimes stuff gets stuck in the plunger. So we'll have to check that. Okay, pressure transducer tubing we talked about. Next, possibly if the heating element is defective, we would have to do a resistance test on the heating element. Actually, we can do that pretty easily. If you have a multimeter, you unplug the unit, and then you unplug these two brown wires and you plug your multimeter into it, and it should read either 9 or 11 ohms. If you want to go that far, we can talk about it. It could be the PC board is defective. The heater relay is not working. Could be that possibly. There's a couple tests we can run to do that. And then, like I said in the beginning of the video, first thing I would do is pull out all the instruments and run an empty cycle, because the last thing on this error code talks about sterilizer being overloaded. So I would first make sure that your sterilizer is not overloaded and then run a cycle. And if problem persists, then we can go down this road. So if you like this video, please share it. Please subscribe to our channel and stay tuned for more Midmark troubleshooting videos.